So welcome, everybody. Such a blessing to be here. Take a comfortable seated position. So originally, I had intended this to be a Beyond Lotus workshop. So it's kind of like, so now you found your lotus. Now what, right? So, and I know that a lot of us are, are working towards Lotus still. So what I'm going to do is I decided to integrate kind of a Lotus 101 working towards it. And then I'll teach everything in stages. So stage one, if you're working on Lotus, that's where you'll be. And then stage two, you'll start working into Lotus with different variations, okay? So I've planned a few variations in different kind of, with different postures, kind of using Lotus as a vinyasa almost. So one of the things that's super important is that the lotus marks, in philosophy, it marks the spiritual unfolding of the practitioner. So it carries a lot of weight, a lot of value. And I was thinking, like, you guys are Canadian. In BC, you guys are a lot of A-type physical personalities, right? So you guys are very strong in your practice. You guys have a lot of fire, a lot of drive. And I was thinking about that this morning. I was thinking, well, when you unfold something, the lotus is very delicate, right? And a lot of times we really want the unfolding or the opening to happen now. Want it today. And one of the things that you realize is that when you are working with something so delicate and so precious, like your body, right, it takes time. It takes time to unfold. And if you start pulling the leaves apart on a lotus, they actually just come off, right? I have never done that, but I am assuming, right? So as we practice today, we're going to cover a little bit of the biomechanics of the knee and the hip, which are specific to the opening of the lotus. And this is the kind of workshop that hopefully you go away with a little bit of knowledge about how to go where you want to go. Like, what is the roadmap to get me there? And then once I'm there, what can I do with it, okay? So for those of you who are not getting into Lotus fully by the end of the class, please do not leave thinking that you have failed, okay? This is something you're going to be able to come back to many, many times. And ultimately, one of the things that is great about the Lotus is that the seeds that are planted are viable for many, many years. So the oldest known seed that has been germinated is 1,300 years. So the seed was found and they germinated. It was 1,300 years old. But when the conditions are right, when the conditions are right for the seed, the flower will blossom. And that's for all of us, you know. And yes, we're going to be taking this into a physical aspect today in our practice. We're going to be literally trying to align the body in ways that it unfolds naturally and harmoniously. But ultimately, we want to go beyond that. We want to use the physical to get to something deeper, okay? Now, to get to something deeper, you don't have to do lotus. You don't have to be able to do a handstand. You don't have to be able to do a crazy backbend. You have to be able to be in tune with yourself. And ultimately, little practices like this, where we're focusing on little aspects like the knees and the hips, it just deepens the awareness of your practice. It deepens the awareness of who you are and where you are. So let's get started. Take a comfortable seated position. Sit up tall, take your shoulders back. And then just close your eyes, soften your eyes closed. Going back all the way to the Upanishads, which are ancient scriptures, the lotus carries great power and value. When you tune into yourself, when the mind gets clear and the body is at ease, there is a lifting of light that comes from within. It is the revealing of your true self, your truth. And those who glimpse it, those who see it, describe it as the unfolding of the lotus light. In the heart of the lotus is great beauty. In the heart of the practitioner, there is great beauty. Advanced yoga is about unfolding that beauty in a way that brings harmony and light to your life and to your practice. So simple. So simple. Bring your hands together at your heart center. In the scripture, it is called the lotus heart, because this light energy seems to rise up from someplace within in the center. When you bring your hands to prayer pose, you naturally bring them to your center. You know how to align to your truth. You know how to settle into your truth. It is instinctive. From this sweet place within, let's share our voices. We're going to chant Om three times. And then just listen to the people around you and try to align your voice with their voice in a way that just brings beauty to the room. Take a deep inhale. Bow your head. Release your hands. Lift your head. Open your eyes. Okay. So I just wanted to cover something real quick. So the joints, the two major joints that we're going to be working with today will be your knee and your hip. Okay? Your knee and your hip. So just interlace your hands like this. Just bring your fingers like this. Okay? And you're just going to close the hands and open them. Yeah. And you don't have to go crazy. Just nice. Okay. So what your hands are doing is they're creating a hinging action. Okay. It's an open and close. There's no rotation. It's just open, close, open, close. In your body, you have joints that are called hinge joints. Your knee is one of them. It's designed to do exactly this. Open and close. Okay. Now take your hand like a cup, like this. Take your other hand and make a fist and just place it into the cup. And keeping the cup closed around the fist, just move your hand in circles. You can be quite free like that, yeah? There you go. Go a little crazy, man. Get a little wild in there. Yeah, that is your hip. There's a party going on in there, right? Cool, he already started to sweat. Okay, so that is your hip joint. It's called a ball and socket, okay? And the way that your body is designed is that as it moves from the center, from the core to the periphery, the parts get smaller. So they actually start to move faster as they move down. This will be a big thing that we'll be playing with today, because when we start aligning the body, typically, especially in lotus, the body will want to turn from the knee because the parts are smaller, okay? But remember, the knee is only designed to do this. It's the hip that does this, okay? So we're going to break that down in some standing poses today. And literally, if you left with nothing else except for the vibrant sounds of whales under the sea, right? If you left with nothing else, I would want you to leave with this mantra: bend at the knee, turn at the hip. Okay, bend at the knee, turn at the hip. That will take your practice and keep it healthy for the rest of your life. Okay, stand in Tadasana. Bend at the knee and turn at the hip. I thought he was just going to jump into the jam, but no, it's just nice, brother. All right, stand at the front of your mat. Take your feet hip distance apart. Okay, with your feet hip distance apart, just place your ankles underneath your hips so it's like sitting bone distance apart. Take your feet wider. There you go. And then look down at your feet and make sure that your heels are pointing straight back. One of your heels or both of your heels will tend to pull in. This is typically reflecting tight hip flexors, tight hips. And then tone your legs. And then on your next inhale, just lift your chest. Make the upper body brighter. Now, philosophically, you are carrying this light, beautiful energy of the lotus within your heart. So you want to create a vessel that honors that beauty. So you want to align your shoulders, align your rib cage to create space for that light. On your next inhale, very nice. On your next inhale, take your arms overhead, reach for the sky. And as you reach for the sky, the action, because of the way your brain works, will always go from your central nervous system out to the muscle. So it moves from the inside outwards. And your skin is the very last thing to actually receive the signal. So even start from your bones. Let your bones be a little bit more expressive through the center of your body. And let your breath start to fill the entire space of your body. On your next exhale, bow forward and touch the earth. Uttanasana, forward fold. Nice, Todd. Good, Justine. And then as you touch the ground, touch your fingers to the ground, fingertips. And then keeping your fingertips touching the ground, press them into the ground so there's an active connection. Tone your legs and then use the toning of your legs, the strength of your legs, to even straighten your legs. So as long as your fingertips are touching the ground, your back is safe. And those of you guys who have been doing many, many classes over the last couple of days, you're probably feeling it in your legs. I don't care. Okay. Compassion is really not one of my strengths. On your next inhale, lift and lengthen. Ardha Uttanasana, full stretch through the heart. And as you stretch to your heart, you can either keep your fingertips on the floor, or to get more opening in the back, you can bring your hands to the top of your shins. And then tone your legs, make your legs strong. Those are pillars of strength. And use the strength of your legs to stretch your spine, stretch the vertebrae, open it up. Very good. On your exhale, bow forward, Uttanasana, forward fold. Very nice. Take your hands to your hips, take your shoulders back with an open heart, rise to standing. Carry the openness of your heart all the way to the top of the head. Take the arms overhead, reach for the sky. As you reach for the sky, embrace the space between your arms. You don't have to close it up, but almost like you're holding this massive vessel between your hands that this lotus is going to actually grow from. And then keeping the space strong, soften the shoulders away from the neck. Very good. On your exhale, bow forward and touch the earth. Uttanasana, forward fold. Lift and lengthen, Ardha Uttanasana, full stretch through the heart. Good. Step back, plank pose. Good. Set your shoulders directly above the wrist. Tone the arms, tone the legs. And on your exhale, lower all the way down to the ground. Good. Lower your hips, point your toes. Take your fingertips off the mat, but place them on the floor. So they're just going to be off the mat so that you're a little bit wider. Press to your fingertips. Take your shoulders back and stretch your heart up and forward. Your fingers can be on the floor. Press them into the ground. Strong, strong, strong. Yeah, fingertips, so you get a lot of space in your chest. Now, using a strong connection to the earth, stretch your heart forward, but at the same time, the roots of your legs, stretch them back. Make an opening through the back body. Good. Downward facing dog. Press it all the way back. Nice, Ashley. So your fingers and your feet, anything that touches the ground is a part of the root. So plant your hands, plant your feet, tone your arms, and then from your back of your heart, stretch out so that your arms get more rooted. Your hips will get more free as you push them back. There you go. Keep your hips high in dog pose and then shift your heels to the left. So you're just going to shift your heels to the left. That's it. Just a little rotation. Your toes will be pointing to the right. But keep the hips and the upper body in dog pose. And then out of the right side of your body, stretch, press out. And as you press to the outside of the body, get the outer edge of your left foot a little more rooted on your mat and get more of an opening. That's it. Stretch. Open up the outer right hip. Good. Come back to center. Switch sides. Take it over to the other side. And then keeping the hips high, stretch to the left side of the body. Press out to your left arm. Good. Come back to center. Step forward to meet your hands. Uttanasana, forward fold. Lift and lengthen. Ardha Uttanasana, full stretch to the heart. Good. Bow in, forward fold. Good. One more time like that. Lift and lengthen. Ardha Uttanasana. Good. Todd, get some opening in your spine, brother. That's it. Bow in, forward fold. Take your hands to your hips. Take your shoulders back. Open heart, open throat. Rise to stand. Very good. Take your arms overhead. Reach for the sky. On your exhale, bow forward. Uttanasana, forward fold. Lift and lengthen, Ardha Uttanasana, full stretch. Good, step back, plank pose. Good, Annabelle, strong arms, strong legs. Emily, take your hands wider. Ryan, take your hands wider. And then use your legs, Ryan, to keep your hips lifted. Lift it up. That's it, brother, keep it strong. Lower down, halfway, chaturanga. Hold. Lower your hips from here, point your toes, Bhujangasana, cobra. Good. Is it Liana? Liana. Press your hands strong, Liana. Use them. Those are your roots. And out of the roots, grow, stretch. That's it. Open up. Be strong in your hands. Downward facing dog. Press it all the way back. Good. Strong arms. Tone the arms towards center. And then from the back of your heart, create a deeper opening, a stronger opening. There you go. Good, Megan. Stretch your arms straight, left. Stretch your arms straight. That's it. More, more, more. Stretch them straight. Push back, push back. Look between your hands. Bend your knees and playfully jump Uttanasana, forward fold. Good. Lift and lengthen, Ardha Uttanasana, full stretch, bow in. Hands in your hips, shoulders back, heart open, rise to stand. Full stretch, take the arms overhead. As you stretch the arms overhead, take your arms slightly behind your ears and then start to lean back a little bit. What's going to keep you from falling back is strong legs. Tone your legs, press your legs back, root your tailbone down so you get longer through the spine. On your exhale, bow forward, Uttanasana, forward fold. Okay, very nice. Lift and lengthen, Ardha Uttanasana. Step back plank pose. Mindfully set the hands, mindfully set the feet. Good, Ashley, soften the left fingers. Soften the hand a little bit. Yeah. So there is, you can be super strong, but also be very artistic and very sweet and beautiful in your postures. Keep your throat open. Stretch forward to your heart as you lower down. Chaturanga, lower down, halfway. Lower the hips, point the toes, Bhujangasana Cobra. There you go, the music's picking up. We're gonna amp it up a little bit. Downward facing dog, press it all the way back. There you go. Look between your hands, bend your knees and float, Uttanasana. Even a light hop is fine. Lift and lengthen, Ardha Uttanasana, full stretch. Bow in, hands on the hips, shoulders back, heart open, rise to stand. Full stretch, hug the space between your arms, hug the space between your legs, and then start to lean back. As you lean back, press down to your legs, super strong roots in the legs. On your exhale, bow forward, Uttanasana, forward fold. Lift and lengthen, Ardha Uttanasana, full stretch to your heart. Good, step back plank pose. Check the hands, check the feet. Megan, turn your hand out on the right arm, turn it out. Yeah, not so far, just so see how hers are pointing forward, like that. Now straighten your arms, super strong through the arms. That's it, hold the strength in your arms, lower down, halfway Chaturanga. Good, Charlotte. Lower the hips, point the toes, Bhujangasana Cobra. Good, take your hands a little bit wider, wider. There you go, like that. Now press your arms and stretch your heart forward. Good, smile a little bit. Downward facing dog, press it all the way back. Nice job. Tone your arms, tone your legs, and stretch back. Open the side body, open the outer edges of the hips, even in dog pose. Look between your hands and bend, jump, Uttanasana, forward fold. Lift and lengthen, Ardha Uttanasana, full stretch. Bow in, forward fold. Hands on your hips, shoulders back, heart open, rise to stand. Full stretch, shake the arms overhead, reach for the sky. On your exhale, fold forward, Uttanasana, touch the ground. Lift and lengthen, Ardha Uttanasana, Chaturanga, straight back. Place the hands and jump. Good. Bhujangasana Cobra. Open up the heart. Good. Step back plank pose. Nice job. Step your right foot forward. Come onto fingertips. Good. Okay, now pause. Check your feet. Make sure your feet are as wide as your hips. So remember, the body will start to move at different rates as it gets to the edges. On your next inhale, rise and bring your hands to your hips. Now your knee is defined, the position of your knee should be defined by the position of your foot. So look at your front foot and get your knee right on top of it. Right on top of it. That's it. Now, keeping the knee right on top of the ankle, start to stretch your back leg straighter. And then take a little bit of a straightening out of your front leg so it gets straight. So we're going to hinge it open. There you go. And then you're going to bend it back in. So that's a hinge. Again, open it up. There you go. And bend it a little deeper. There you go. Now go to exactly a 90-degree angle. 90-degree angle in your front leg. So if I got a block and I put it on your front thigh, I wouldn't want it to slide down, right? So 90-degree angle. From your hips, stretch to your back leg and float your arms overhead. Reach for the sky. That's it. Fantastic. Bring your hands to prayer pose. Keep the back leg straight, super strong back leg, and take a twist. Take your left elbow to the outside of the right thigh. There you go. As you take the twist, you will feel that your outer right hip will move up and forward. Tone your legs and take the outer right hip back and in. And even the outer edge of the hip can move down strong. That's it. This is the beginning of Lotus. This is the opening of the outer hip flexors. Open your chest. Open your heart. Good. Come back to center. Step to plank pose. Set the hands. Set the feet. Hold space. Plank. Be in plank. Don't anticipate chaturanga. Tone your arms. Tone your legs. Open your heart and stretch forward to your heart. Very good. Downward facing dog. Press it all the way back. Right about now, are you guys wishing that you would have went for brunch? It's too late. You come in. We lock the doors. Nobody leaves. Good. Step your left foot forward. Come on to fingertips. Okay, quickly check the distance of your legs. Not only front to back, but side to side. Front to back, we want to get the knee over the ankle. Side to side, hip distance. Back toes facing forward. On your next inhale, rise. Bring your hands to your hips. There you go. There you go. Bend your front leg to a square. Right over your front ankle. That's perfect. There you go. Now open your throat. Open your throat. That's it. There you go. Now straighten your front leg just a little bit. Take the pressure out of the connection. And then right in a straight line, bend the front knee back in. That is honoring the integrity of the joint in the knee. How's that feel? Straighten your front leg again. How's that knee feeling on the meniscus? It's okay? There you go. Right in line with your front foot. Straight point. Bend the front knee again. Straight forward. That's it. Float your arms overhead. Reach for the sky. Now straighten your back leg with all you got. Don't change this. Straighten your back leg. I'll tell you when it's straight. You just keep going. That's straight. Keep it straight. Now bend your knee deeper. Bend it deeper. Bend it deeper. Bend it deeper. There you go. Hands in prayer pose. Take a twist. Fantastic. Once you take the twist, again, settle in the center. And the prayer pose doesn't need to be hard. It should be fully connected, but also sweet and soft. Press your outer left hip back, in, and even down. So the outer edge of the hips wraps down. So the bone is still in line with your front shin. Good. Awesome. Keep all of that and rotate this down. More down, more down. Cool. There you go. Come back to center. Step to plank pose. Okay, downward facing dog. Press it all the way back. All right. Come to your hands and your knees and pull it down just a little bit. Okay. Come to your hands and your knees, and we'll gather around Abdul's mat. Okay? So come. I just want you to see something, but also I want the camera to be able to see it. Oh, he's got a line in the middle of his mat. I didn't even plan this. For the next heated series of standing poses to open the hips, we're going to focus on something, okay? So come into downward facing dog. We'll face turn around. Okay. All right. Step your right leg forward right on the center of that line. There you go. So your foot also has a center point, okay? That determines how gravity falls on the foot. Spin your back foot flat so the arch of your foot is also on that line. Good. All right. So when we come into Lotus, one of the biggest things that we're going to have to do is work external rotation in, for example, the front leg. On both legs eventually, but on this one we're going to do it in this pose. We're going to start it here. So when he comes into warrior two legs, and a lot of the standing poses are actually built off of this posture right here, right? And what you see is that his knee, well, first of all, his feet are able to be on this line relatively easy. But as you get up in here on the top hip, it's very hard to get it on this line. Can you feel that? Oh, yeah. Yes, right? And his knee, his brain will start telling his leg what to do, but his knee will want to do the action, not his hip, because his hip is so big and so muscular. So his job is to keep the foot from moving, keep the knee from moving, and bring the center of this femur bone right on this line. There you go. Check this out. In order to do that, this leg left the line, right? Oh, so tricky, tricky, tricky. Stay on fingertips, stay on fingertips. Press this leg back onto the line, keep it there, and bring only the top of the femur bone onto the line without moving your knee. I know. That's it. Now, on this line, stretch the bones of your legs apart. Stretch, as if no, stretch, keep it bent, as if you were moving them apart on the line. Yeah. Inhale to rise, warrior two. Why are you sweating, man? It's early. Stretch it out. Yeah, see how the knee wavers away from this line? This never moves. You move from the core. this back, this forward. So this moves back, this moves forward. That's it. And then from the center, they move apart. That will blossom your flower. Good. Awesome. He's going to be walking out of here like... Okay, so usually I use straps for this, but I think everybody can create an imaginary line on their mat, right? Okay, we're going to do an imaginary line just like he has there. Now, here's the thing. Again, we don't pull the pedals apart, okay? Some of you guys are really strong. He's a strong dude. Do not use your physical power to force the opening, okay? Create the vision, align the vision, and then just be patient. It'll open. All right? Nice job, brother. All right, come on to your mats, downward facing dog. Give us blossoming flower up a hand. Okay. All right, downward facing dog. Press it all the way back. Okay, now imagine, I even sometimes use the edge of my mat as a line, but imagine you have a straight line in your mat. Step your right foot forward on that line. What the hell? Take your whole body and move it to the right edge of your mat. We're going to use the very edge of your mat as an actual line. I don't trust your imaginations. This is Whistler, after all. Now spin your back foot flat, yeah, and the arch of your foot will be on that line as well. Your back foot will be parallel. Now bend your front knee to a square, right? You may have to lengthen your stance a little bit. It's totally cool. The center of your foot will be on the line. Stop, and you'll notice that the center of your knee will pull to the right. Get it right on the line. There you go. Hold it on the line. Take the outer left hip back also on the line. You're taking the outer edge, the middle of the outer leg, and then draw your left thigh bone onto the right thigh bone onto the line as well. So you come right into a physical space of center. That's it. Then stay on your fingertips, and from this place, stretch your heart forward. Open it up. Open. Yeah, stay on fingertips and stretch it. You should be able to feel your leg on the right side working, especially as high up as you can imagine it, working inward. Yes? Most of you, if you're doing it properly, you should not be able to walk tomorrow. Good. Downward facing dog. Press it all the way back. Nice work. Step the left foot forward right onto the line. Oh, you may have to move the line to the left side of your mat, okay? Now, spin the back foot flat. The middle of the back foot will be on that line as well. Now, your front foot will be easily on the line. So, Todd, take your whole left foot. Half your foot will be off your mat. Yeah, that's it. That's it. And then if you looked at the center of your knee, one half of your kneecap will be in your mat space, and the other half of your kneecap will not. Hold that. And then take your outer right hip back onto the line. You'll have to swing it back and then swing hard your left sit bone inward until the center of your left thigh is right on that line. And then from that line, stretch forward to your heart. Stretch it forward, super strong. That's it. Shorten your stance a little bit. Shorten it, shorten it, shorten it, shorten it, shorten it, shorten it, shorten it. Stop right there. There you go. And then right here, stay here, stay here. And then stretch the bones of your legs as if they were gliding on that line. Stretch them apart. Lengthen them. Nice, Liz. Oh, breathe. Good. Dog pose. Press it all the way back. Good. Step your right foot forward. Spin your left foot flat. There you go. Same alignment. And then this time, you don't have to use the edge of your mat, but start to create that visual center on your mat. Steph, you take a longer stance. On your inhale, rise, Virabhadrasana 2, Warrior 2. Now in Warrior 2, you're still working, and you'll see actually like the knee will want to pull to the right because it's moving faster. Yeah, keep the knee in and work the right sit bone super strong inward. And then from the center, glide your bones apart. Move the bones apart. Steffi, as you move the bones apart, your front knee will even get deeper into the pose. Sorry, Sasha. Good, there you go. Good, and then soften your gaze. The lotus should not be angry. No angry lotus here today. Good, step to plank pose. Nice job. Good, plank, open the heart, downward facing dog. Good, Ashley. Step the left foot forward, spin your right foot flat. Check out the legs, align the bones of the legs. Start from the feet, the back foot will be flat. Good, very good awareness, Bonnie. That's it. Bend the front knee right on top of the ankle. Scoop your right hip back, left sit bone in. Rise, Virabhadrasana 2, warrior 2. Arms right in line with the shoulders. There you go. And then as you bend that front knee, take a longer Stein, Sasha. Longer, 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 longer. Now bend. Your front knee has to hold the intention. And then really strong, bring the left thigh bone into center. That's it. And then from the center, bend a little bit deeper. Bend a little bit deeper. Glide the bones of your legs apart. That's it. Very good. Very good. The lotus as the seed, it has to break through stuff to get to the surface, right? So you got to do the work. Good. Step to plank pose. Top of a push-up. As I told you, compassion, not one of my strengths. Good. Downward facing dog. Press it all the way back. You guys are doing awesome. Step your right foot forward. Spin your left foot flat. Take your right arm to the inside of your right leg on fingertips. On fingertips. Nice, Ashley. Take your left hand to your hip. Good. You're going to, Annabelle, take a longer stance. Left hand on your hip. Place it on the hip. Back foot flat, Sarah. Back foot flat. And align the bones just like you did before. Same line. Same line. That's it. Now use your right arm against your right leg to create a stable line of center. That knee will not move because your arm is there. And scoop your right sit bone in strong. Take your shoulders back. Stretch your left arm overhead. Parsvakonasana. That's it. Reach for the front of the room. Palm face down. That's it. As you reach forward, your front knee stays right on top of the ankle. Right on top. Now work hard to bring that right sit bone in. That's it. That's it. Beautiful. Good. Step to plank pose. Dog pose. Press it all the way back. Step your left foot forward. Spin your right foot flat. Align the legs. Front heel in line with the arch of the back foot. Jamie, move your back foot towards Anne. That's it. Take your left arm on the inside of the left leg. Left hand on fingertips. Good. Come on to fingertips, brother. Fingertips. Yeah. Give yourself some space. So hold space between the right arm and the, left arm, left knee, and work strong to bring the left sit bone in harmony with your left knee. It will tend to pull to the left. Work hard in your legs. Bring it in. Open up your shoulders. Stretch your right arm overhead. Reach for the front of the room. Palm face down. Good, Dana. That's it, man. That's it. That's it. Open up your fingers. Look in the direction of your heart. Yeah, so your heart's facing this way. Yeah, there's your heart. Welcome to your heart. Good. Stretch through your arms. Full stretch. Press the bones of your legs apart. Step to plank pose. Good job. Good, Lindsay. Fantastic. Good use of the legs. Dog pose. Press it all the way back. Step your right foot forward. Spin your left foot flat. Align the front heel with the arch of the back foot. Take your right arm to fingertips on the inside of the right leg. Take your left hand to your hip and pause. Same setup. We're going to do a little something different here. Make sure your front legs, your stance is long enough to get your front knee to a square. Use the power of your legs to make lightness in your upper body. Take your right arm underneath your right leg. Take your left arm behind you. Take a gentle, sweet bind. Gentle, sweet bind. So once you clasp your fingers, even if you can't touch, work in that direction. Work towards it. There you go. Press your legs. And then keeping your shoulders back, press your right sit bone in strong to the midline. Open your chest, open your heart. Good. Keep the bind, bow your chest towards the ground so your whole body, upper body is facing the ground. Release, keep the bind, but loosen the tension around your hamstring and straighten your right leg. Loosen the tension. Your arm should not be touching your hamstring when you straighten it. Once you straighten it, and only when it's straight, start to lengthen your torso forward, take your shoulders back for bound Trikonasana. Bound Trikonasana. You got it, Todd. You got it, man. That's it. Keep working. Keep working. Hold it strong. Good. Step forward to bound Uttanasana. Bound Uttanasana. So if we lost you and your mind is totally fried, look around you. There will be somebody in a bind with their legs at the front of their mat. There you go. Yeah, you got it. You got it, Annabelle. Just like that, love. I got you. Good. Fantastic. Now, taking your shoulders back, keeping your knees bent, rise to standing, holding the bind for Sparga Vijasana prep. You're going to keep your left knee, left leg straight, right knee bent, right knee bent, right knee bent, right knee bent. So your right knee is a hinge, shoulders back, heart open, left leg strong, and from your knee, only from your knee, start to straighten your right leg to the best of your ability. That's it. You got it. It's a hinge, open from the hinge. Good. Release, bow forward, and unbind. Oh. We will consider this the water that the lotus seed needs to eventually blossom. Good. Lift and lengthen, Ardha Uttanasana. Good. Step back, dog pose, all the way back. Good. Step your left foot forward, spin your right foot flat. Take your left arm to the inside of your left leg. Good, Sasha, longer stance, love. Good. Take your left arm underneath your left leg. Take your right arm behind you for a bound Parsvakonasana. Nice, Liz. Good. Bind doesn't have to be super strong. It's mainly just as a container of center. Use your left thigh bone moving towards center to create a stronger opening in the hips. Press your legs apart. Good. Very good, you guys. Bow your chest towards the floor. One more time. Soften the connection around the hamstring and then press your left leg towards straight. Your left arm should not be touching the hamstring. There you go. It could still be way, it could still be near the hamstring, so this can still move back. Shoulders back now. That's it. But the leg stretches independently. Step forward, Uttanasana, forward fold and a bind. There you go. Good, Annabelle. Very good work. Very good work. Hold a strap, Annabelle. You got it. Hang on strong. Inhale to standing, balancing on your right leg, left leg is bent. Svarga Vijasana, prep. There you go. The opening happens here to your standing leg and your shoulders. So press your standing leg strong, take your shoulders back, and then to the best of your ability, stretch your left leg right from the knee, stretch it out. Good. Bow in, Uttanasana, forward fold. Nice job. Very good. Shake out your legs, everybody. Good. Lift and lengthen, Ardha Utta. Good. Dog pose. Okay. Pigeon prep. Bring your left shin forward, right knee to the ground. Left shin forward, right knee to the ground. Okay. So this action of pigeon prep, moving the knee to the side, this is the beginning stages of the actual physicality of lotus, okay? So get your knee moving to the left, wider than your hips. It doesn't have to go crazy, but just wider. How far? Well, when your pubic bone is in the middle of your shin, that's about right, okay? Your hips have to remain square. So in lotus pose, when you come into lotus, your hips are not turning with the knee. They stay square. So as you bring the foot in, hips square. Then, staying on your fingertips, walk your right leg straight back. Switch legs. And switch legs. Good. Try not to hinge to the left. There's an asymmetry in the body, but you gotta stay square, okay? Good. Bow forward on your fingertips. Walk your torso directly to the right, so you're just creating a rotation. There you go. As you walk to the right, keep your back toes tucked under, your entire back leg facing the floor, rotate, this has to move down. Good. Good. And then with all you have, the back knee can stay on the floor, but with all you have, take your left knee back. Good. Come back to center, downward facing dog. All right, come to your hands and your knees real quick. I want to show something with the knee. Come over to Abdul's mat again. Let me use your mat for a second, brother. I will use you. Turn around. Face me, actually, here. Do pigeon prep. I want to show you something with the knee. Do you mind if he sweats a little on your mat? If it's really bad, we'll get you a new one. Okay. Left shin forward. Okay. Now, what I was talking about with the knee is the knee will move at different rates. Keep your back toes tucked under so the back foot is stable. Okay, stop. Take your hands onto fingertips. Okay. When you watch his knee joint, there's a pulsation. He rocks back and forth. Okay. because his knee is on the floor, like his shin is on the floor, this is one part of his leg. His other part of the leg is actually lifting into the hip like this. It actually looks like this, okay? So what you see is because this is designed to go like this. Remember, we talked about this as the hinge. So when he's in pigeon prep like this, because of gravity, his bones will actually want to do this, okay? So your ligaments between your knee, they will actually start to get strained by your knee doing this, okay? So without moving your foot, I'm going to put this block here, and you're going to pull your knee away from the block. There you go, like that. And see, that's where the opening happens. Now he's actually brought his knee from here to here. Now the hinge is honored, okay? You feel it in your hips, I know. Because these what we call in yoga, these are called bastard muscles, right? They don't want to open. They're like the big guys. There he goes, hey, you little guys, you guys open. I just do an accent because it's... Okay, I got to be sensitive to that. Okay, now bow forward on your forearms. Bow forward on your forearms. And then walk your torso to the left. Walk it to the left. Walk it to the left. Walk it to the left. Okay, now I'm going to place this block here again. And there you go. There you go. And then you'll see that the flower will shimmer, right? There you go. And then every time he goes back, that's a new opening. I can reshift the block. And he goes deeper. Walk it over to the more. More. You got it. More. More. There you go. Pull the knee. Pull the knee. Yeah. Good. This rotation here, when the foot folds in, is lotus. He's in. Okay? Good. Come back to center. Good job. Yeah. Good. Okay. So I see a lot of people when they're doing lotus, and I know it's taught like this sometimes, is the leaning over to the side. And the reason why that's taught like that is so that the, give me that block. Is so that the knee is as a unit, the joint itself is stable by the floor, okay? But that creates a little compression in the sacrum in the back. So what we do is if we know that that's what we're looking for, when we come onto our mat, we can use the power of the legs to pull this energy back into alignment, okay? Now, it's our ability to hold and sustain that will determine if the pose is safe for us or not, okay? When we cannot sustain it anymore, we come out. It's totally cool. Okay, or if you can, you just wait for Uncle Chrissy. Uncle Chrissy will bring you out. Okay, bring onto your mat. Downward facing dog. Let's do it. We did the left side last time, right? Now do the right side, everyone. All right, right shin forward, pigeon prep. Just like he showed, right shin forward. So your right leg has to, your right foot should be active. There should be a sense of presence in your right foot. And then walk your hips back and then pull your right knee away from the front of your mat so that you're getting the knee, the femur, back into the socket. You feel that opening? It is so subtle, but it's super powerful and it'll keep your knee healthy. Bow forward onto your forearms. Good. How are you doing, Tia? Yeah, you still like me? She's like by a very thin margin. Good. Walk your torso to the left. Walk your torso to the left. Good. That's it. As you walk your torso to your left, use your forearms for support. So keep your upper body lifted. Don't let your upper body just collapse. And then with as much power as you can gather in your right leg, pull that right femur bone back so that the knee joint has some space. Yeah, that's it. Good, Paul. Keep working it, brother. Then, Paul, keep that and walk your left leg back because you just created space. Walk it back. Go crazy. Go crazy. Back, back. Your left leg. Your other left leg. Move it back. Straight back. Now bring the knee down. Walk your torso more to the left. Move it over. Good. Paul, look towards me with your head, bro. Yeah. There you go. That's it. Smile a little bit. It's just yoga. Now pull your right hip back. Super strong, brother. Yeah. That's it. Keep going. Keep going. I'll tell you when to stop. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. That's it, man. That's it. Good. Come back to center. Downward facing dog. All right. Come to your hands and your knees. I'm going to show something in stages. Okay. You can bring the music down just a little bit. Okay. For this one, we will do, we will use partners. Okay. So your partner will be a wall. All right. I'm going to show three different stages. Three? Maybe three. Okay. So three stages. of this post. So we're going to start to work the action of Lotus, okay? For those of you guys that are already getting into Lotus, your hips should be open now that you'll start moving in. For those of us who are still working on it, we're going to start to work the form, okay? Essentially, what we're going to do is when we go upside down, we're going to create a number four with our legs, like this, okay? So we're just going to hop. We're going to be a little bit playful. The reason why I'm taking you upside down to do this action is because when you're upside down, your hands are not going to be involved. So, for example, the one time that I blew my knee in Lotus, I was using my hands. I was pulling it in like this, okay? And my hips weren't open, so it popped the knee, okay? So when you're upside down, you can only move your hips to the ability that they can move, all right? So we're going to do downward facing dog. You're going to step 1 foot forward, cross your ankle across the knee. Can everybody see? Yeah. And then with your knee crossed like the number four, you're just going to do a little hop like this. Hop. One. Hop. Two. Okay. And you can switch legs. Okay. Stage two, you walk your feet in just a little bit. Turn to the side, just like that opening dog pose we did. Bring 1 foot into Lotus. This one, you can use your hand only to guide it. Don't pull it. It'll let it go up as much as it can. Bend the knee. Same action. And then rotate. 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 Okay? Stage three. Rotate. Pull in. Okay? If you need a stage four, I'll create one for you, okay? So for this one, I just want you to be playful. The main goal is to not use your hands, just to feel the range of motion and to get used to it without using your hands, okay? So find a partner. Your partner will be a wall. Hold each other by the hips. Kate, show real quick. Do number fours. No, she's like, stage four? Do the... In my notes, I call them fours, jumping fours. There you go. A little bend in the knee and hop. Good. Back down, touch and go. Like that. Super. I'm just holding by the hips. I'm creating a barrier so she can't fall. Good. And release. Okay? So you can try number fours, half Lotus, and then bend the second knee. It can come in or not. And then do a few each. Okay? Let's try it. Go. Bonnie, and you can start working floating as you're going, okay? As you're jumping, start to float so we can start to work to Kukutasana, arm balance with the Lotus, okay? Yes. Good, Jamie. That's it. Good, Amanda. That's it. Good. Yeah. The second leg will be bent once you take off, okay? Your right leg will go bent like a little. Yeah, but arms stay straight. Arms stay straight. Good. Now bend the top knee as well. Yeah, and then pull the knee in. That'll get you tighter and open in the hips. Yeah. You feel that? Yeah, that's it. Good. Bend the top knee. Bend the top knee. And then pull the knee forward. Pull the knee forward. Pull the knee forward. Bend it. Pull it. Yeah, like this. There you go. Feel that in your hips? Yeah, baby. Good. Come down. Switch it up. You're like, come on, man. Keep it going. Switch it up. Very good. Good. Start going to half Lotus. Good. Good. Fantastic spot. That was great. Good. Let's see it again. Let's see it again. Yes, that's it. Stronger the hips. Hold her right away so she when she goes up, go. There you go. There you go. Let your leg go up. Open it up. Open it up. There you go. Good. Switch legs right here. Yeah, pull it in strong. There you go. There you go. Bend your top leg. Bend it. Bend it at a 90. Bend it at a 90. Now turn it from the hip. Turn. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Good. Back to center. All the way up. Open it up. Good. Do you feel that action?
Yeah.
boom, boom, and then there's like a rotation, right? Are you in full lotus already? Okay. Try to get full lotus and handstand. Help her spot. She can go up in the handstand first, Ashley, and then pull it in, okay? Let's see it. Yes. Let's help her. Let me help her. Go, jump. Move your back foot forward. Forward, forward, and go. There you go. Bend your top knee a little more. There you go. Now rotate at the hip. Turn at the hip. Yeah, there you go. Bring this shin to this shin. Press them together. There you go. That's it. That's it. Good. Open it up. Good. And come down. Did you feel that action?
Yeah.
She's like, okay, downward facing dog. We're going to do some more of that. Don't worry. All right, come to a seated position at the front of your mat. Okay. Did you guys get that action when you're in the number four and then your top leg bends like this and you can do that? Yeah? Okay, cool. Cross Gomukhasana, right knee over left knee, right knee over left knee. Yeah, right knee over left knee. Just knees on top of each other. So actually, that's Agni Stambhasana. We're going to do that in a second. All the way over. Oh. Oh. All right. Now, use your hands to press the knees a little closer together. There you go. And immediately you feel it in the hips, right? There you go. That's, these muscles are part of the whole circle. All right, so we got to open these. So you can keep the knees working midline and then stretch your heart forward and then bow forward. As you bow forward, don't curl the heart in. Open the heart up so your spine gets long. And you will feel that there's a widening that happens in the back, right? We want to work that widening continuously. So keep that happening. Bow in a little bit deeper. Good. Work the breath. Release tension through the breath. It doesn't have to be forceful. It doesn't have to be hard. It's just mindful. Nice, Emily. Very good. Very good. Stay bowing forward and then turn your torso to the right side. So like at an angle towards me, 45 degrees. Cross your left elbow in front of your right knee, which is the top knee. And as you bow forward, you're going to press your elbow back to stretch your heart forward. And you should feel a couple of petals fall off. There you go. Stretch it forward. Good. Open your throat. Todd, open your throat. Open your throat and stretch. Remember in the like early 80s, we used to do these kind of moves? Right? That's what we're after. Okay? Right, Todd was a wild man in the 80s, I know. Okay. All right, come back to center. Keep your legs as they are. Turn, rotate to the left. Take your right hand to the front of your bottom knee. Your bottom knee. Yeah, so you're just going to grab. That's the top knee. This is the bottom knee. Yeah, your bottom knee. Your arm could be on the other side of the top. Yeah, like that. There you go. Good. Now, with your hand, you're going to pull against your knee. Right? Immediately, you're going to feel it in the IT band. Press your outer left hip down strong, like it weighs like 100 pounds, so it could actually hold you. And then you're going to lean at a 45 degree angle towards the back of your mat. Lean back, Sarah. That's it. Yeah, there you go. And you'll feel that not only your left knee and your left hip want to pop up, you're going to root them down super strong. Root it down. Lean back. Go wild. Go crazy. Todd, wild, crazy, man. Go wild. Go crazy. There you go. Good. You guys feel that in the IT? Good. Come back to center. Switch legs. There was a what? Oh, that. Cross your knees over top of each other. And that's a good point, too. Like when you create heat in your body, heat is one of the dynamic mechanisms to open the muscles, right? So when we build the heat in the room on our own, it's good for the muscles. Knee over knee. There you go. Widen the sit bones, knees. Okay, it's fine. Yeah, you can even do it like that and stretch up. Very good. And bow forward. As you bow forward, carry the opening of your heart forward. Keep the spine long. Keep the heart open. Good, Ryan. More stretch to your heart, brother. More stretch. There you go. Good, Paul. Keep the tongue in the mouth, man. Tongue in the mouth. There you go. And then, Paul, just bring your head center, man. So, and then in the forehead and the eyes, less anguish. Okay? There you go. Good. Stretch it forward, brother. Stretch it forward. That's it. That's it. Fantastic. Very good. Okay, walk your torso over to the left. Take your right elbow to the outside of your left knee and press back. Press back with the arm. There you go. And use the pressing back of the arm. Keep bowing forward even. Yeah. And you'll bow forward in this direction. Like that. Yeah. There you go. Turn a little bit. And as you bow forward, press with this arm so you move forward in that direction more. Yeah, you feel that? Good. And then nice and a bow. And you just wait for the opening. Come back to center. Take your left hand to your bottom knee. Take your right hand behind you on fingertips. And then use your bottom knee as an anchor. And then lean back. Lean back on it. That's it. Very good, you guys. And as you lean back, you'll feel the outer right hip this time, the IT band all the way up into the tensor fascia muscles start to get angry with you, right? And you just communicate, you just say, just chill out. Those are big muscle groups, and they respond to your nervous system very quickly. So we want to open those up. Good. And the whole back row can be a little bit more sexy by leaning back. The whole back row. Yeah, they're a little too sexy, but good. All right, come back to center. Okay. All right, come. We're going to show one more thing. Come over up to Abdul's mat. And then you guys can gather around. Bonnie. Ashley. Come over. And then we'll sit. Trust. We'll make a little circle, yeah? Okay, so just gather around, and you can bring the music down just a little bit. We're going to... I'm trying to move. He wants to square off of me. He's like, I'll match your lotus with my lotus. Okay. All right. So we're going to do a pose called Agni Stambhasana. Okay. Hey, Bonnie, will you hand me a block from the front? Okay. So we'll do all the same legs. You switch legs. Okay. All right. So Agni Stambhasana it's almost lotus. You're almost in lotus. Okay. But we're going to work it gradually. So in Agni Stambhasana, the same thing that's happening here is that there's a hinge joint happening. As the leg comes across center, and this will be the same for lotus, the back side of the knee will tend to flare open while the front side of the knee will tend to close, okay? That will create overstretching in the ligaments on this side of your leg from the IT band down, also the lateral ligaments, okay? So what we're going to do is we come in. It's very, very important that your feet stay active. If your feet are active and your knee is up, no problem, not a big deal. We don't want any of the turning to happen here. We want the turning to happen in the hip. So we're all right leg, right? So you're going to take your left hand underneath the right thigh. You can take the right hand on top. And then if you watch my knee, you're going to see that this part of the knee will open a little bit by the turning of the bone. You see that? And when you do that, you feel a stretch up in the tensor fascia muscle. You feel that? Yeah. So we want to work the muscle tissue so that the whole bone is rotating so that the knee is open. Does that make sense to everybody? Okay, then we'll switch. Okay. We're going to do exactly this cycle. Okay. The leg that's on the top, arm comes underneath, and we're going to rotate out because this leg is actually rotating out very fast. Up here, not as fast because it's bigger. Okay. So you take my hand on the muscles, and I'm just going to help it rotate in that direction. Okay. Now, I'm a strong dude for the most part. I don't have to overkill it, right? Because all we're trying to do is get this aligned. I can actually overline it. I can overturn it, and it would tweak this side of the knee. Not good either. We just want to find the balance. Then once that starts to settle in line, then we can actually bow forward a little bit. You feel that? Good. Now we'll go right from here, move the bottom foot out, we'll support from the shin and just glide the heel in. Glide the heel in. Good. Now once the heel is in, You're going to move this foot forward, and you're going to bring the knee to the ground. Now, do you guys remember why I said bring the knee to the ground? It related to the pigeon prep earlier, because the joint is now stable by the floor. Both sides of the knee will not move now, okay? We will never, never push on the knee. Never. There you go. Good. The knee stays on the floor. That's your grounding. Then we're going to bow forward to release the hips. And then we're just going to glide the bottom foot on. Hold from the shin. Hold from the shin. Hold from the shin. Hold from the shin. Bow forward. Bow forward. Bow forward. Bow forward. There you go. There you go. Bow forward. Nice work. There you go. This will be stage one. Okay. Stage two, we'll come on to fingertips. Lift onto the knees. Bow forward. There you go. Stage three, give me your hand. There you go. Gorakshasana. Good. Okay, ready? Hands flat. Hands flat. Stage four, knees at the wrist.
Stage four.
Stage. Back up a little bit. Okay. Knees at the wrist. Knees at the wrist. One knee up. Second knee up. So glide it up. You got it. You got it. You got it. You got it. Good. Good, Ashley. Keep working it. Yeah, keep working it. Keep working it. Yeah. There you go. I'll wait for you. Go ahead. Yeah. Nice job. Yeah. Nice job. Awesome, love. Awesome. There you go. Awesome. Okay. And when you're sorry, we all just ejected out of that, right? When you come forward, come out as mindful. Most injuries actually occur in lotus coming out of the pose. So when you come out, just bow forward, glide the feet off. Okay. Yeah. When you're coming in, when you're bringing it in, it should glide in smoothly. If it doesn't glide in smoothly, do not use the power of your arms to pull it in. Okay. Just wait for it. It'll open. Start to tune into the sensations. Where am I tight? Why is it not going? Those are the places that we can open. Right? Okay. Understood? Let's do it together. And then I'll give you guys stage 7, 8, 9, 10 as you wish. All right. Agni Stambhasana. Come into a seated position. And I have plenty of blocks, okay? So if your hips are really, really tight and you start coming in, you'll bring the top leg forward off the other leg onto a block, okay? You need a block? That'll be 12:50 at the end of class. And, oh, also there's cushions around too. Okay, cool. All right, let's do right shin on top of left shin. Right shin on top of left shin, okay? Now, immediately when you start to bring the shin across, both shins are crossed. You're actually bone on top of bone. This pose, Agni Stambha, Agni is fire, and Stambha means like a log. So this is called fire log pose. So Annabelle, yeah, so since the ankle doesn't go onto the other knee, you're going to move the block in line with the ankle, and you're just going to rest it on there like that. Okay? Give him the block. And you're going to put it on your, you're going to put it on your right ankle. Yeah, move it forward. There you go, and just hang out like that. There you go. Good. Now, activate the feet. You're going to cross your left arm underneath the right thigh. Underneath the right thigh, thigh bone. There you go. Right hand on the top of the right thigh. Just, yeah, you're just basically, check it out. Check it out, Carmen. She's like, who am I? Who am I? That sounded like my name. You're holding the leg with both hands, and you're just going to turn it out and down. Okay? Not crazy, just so that the knee joint is starting to be protected. You feel that? Then bow, get the ankle on top of knee. A little more. A little more. Aha! And then bow forward. Okay. So stage one is just hanging out here. Stage two, bring your elbows in front of your shins. Elbows in front of your shins. And then using your elbows, press against the shin to stretch your heart forward, and you should feel a dynamic party going on inside. You feel that? She's like, hello, party. Good. Good, switch legs. Okay. All What happened to the rest of the band? All right, cross it over. There you go. Keep the feet active. And then lift through your heart. Take your right arm underneath the left thigh. Take your left hand to the top of the left thigh. And then create the rotations. Yes, see how there's a little shift there? That's what we want, but not over, okay? That's perfect. And then bow forward. Once you get the opening, then bow forward. I'll show you another little trick. Take your hands to the outer edges of your hips with your thumb in the crease. There you go. Yeah. As you stretch forward, use your fingertips to root the glutes back and in. And then using that action, stretch your spine forward even more. You feel that? Yeah. Then forearms in the front of your shins. Use your arms against your shins to stretch your heart forward. There you go. Fantastic. Use your breath. Use the breath. Release the tension through your breath. Get the hips heavy and grounded to the earth. Nice work, man. Very good. Okay. Super sensitive. Inhale to rise. Keep your legs as they are. You're going to take hold of the left shin with your hand in the front of the shin. You're going to use it for support. Just keep it elevated. Move your bottom leg out from underneath. Give it a little space. Now, you're going to bring the heel towards your belly as you bow forward. Heel towards belly as you bow forward. Left knee to the ground. There you go. If your left knee does not come to the ground, you can either put a block so that it stabilizes, yeah, and the knee will work towards there. That's totally cool. And then you'll create the more of a rotation from here
right.
to get it down.
Yeah, yeah.
How's that feel?
Yeah, great.
And that's the opening enough,
yeah.
Okay? We'll work that. Then, only if your knee is touching the ground, you will work, stay bowing forward, and you'll work to slide your right shin on top of your left shin, okay? This one, you can use the hands just to guide it. Bow forward, bow forward, bow forward. This keeps the knees safe on the floor. There you go. Good. Very good. Very good. Knees safe by the floor or blocks. Good. Inhale to rise. Whoa, wait, don't hit. Sorry. Top foot off. Top foot off. Root it. Take it off. Stay bowing forward. Bring your other foot off. You can hold for support to bring it out. Switch legs. Yes, sir. Okay. Switch legs. Okay, bring the, which one comes in next? The right one. The right one next. Left foot comes out slightly forward. Your right knee comes to the ground. Todd, use the block once you're bowing forward, bro, for a stable knee. Your right outer knee should be on something solid. Okay? Bow forward. Yeah, just wait for the opening. Your body will tell you, yeah, that's intense already, right? You just wait for it. You wait for it. You just wait for it. Open up. Use the breath to settle. And then when you're ready, glide your left shin on top of the right, making the action higher happen higher in the hip. Remember, the knee is only bending. It's the turning, to bring the foot in that happens in the hip. Bend at the knee, turn at the hip. All right. Okay. Inhale to rise. Sorry, again. Bow forward and take the legs out. Take the legs out. Keep the knees on the ground as you come out. Okay. We're gonna wrap up with another variation. I have a bunch of variations, but the time is not long enough to go through everything, okay? So I'm going to show you one more that we can do practicing in another class of pose to take the level of the pose higher without creating any danger in the knees. You ready, bro? Okay. Come on to your backs. Okay. You can breathe down. Okay. So we're gonna work Sarvangasana in a shoulder stand, okay, with lotus variations. And I will take, oh, I can't do it because it thinks, what's that? Yeah, just wait for me, though. Okay. Okay, now I'm ready. All right. All right, take your legs overhead. Don't go into full shoulder stand yet. Take the legs overhead. Shoulders back, throat open. Throat open. So this is oftentimes called a cooling pose, and most styles teach it at the end of class. But it's only a cooling pose if there's proper engagement in the neck. Otherwise, the nervous system will actually get agitated. Okay? So keeping your throat open, use your hands to lengthen your spine towards the sky. Your butt will actually not move more over your face. It'll actually lift higher up. There you go. Now take the legs up. Sarvangasana, shoulder stand. Elbows down. Use your arms. Press the arms down into the ground. There you go. And just take your hands alongside the kidneys. There you go. Fantastic. And smile just a little bit. There you go. Good. And I have him smile just to make sure that he's not over tense. Okay? Because if he starts to over tense, go through his whole body. Okay, this is going to be stage one. If you're just practicing getting up, this could be stage one. Even halasana with the legs overhead, totally cool, all right? But if I want to leave you with anything, I want to leave you with vision, okay? What do you do with these things once you have them? Keep growing, okay? So this will be stage one. Stage two, we'll just go right into it, lotus. There you go. See, now he cannot use his hands. He has to kind of burn brain cells. Okay, yeah. Okay. Now, stage 3.5, okay. Don't never turn your head in the Sarvangasana. You're going to use your hand underneath the sacrum like a table, or your right hand. You're going to drop or lower your right butt onto your right hand, and you're going to do parsha. You're going to open your legs to the right 45-degree angle. So you're basically, keep lotus, but you're going to unfold the body, 45. Yeah, there you go. Good. Come back to center. I will show. Good. Switch. Do a little bit to the other side. So see how he's twisting? It's not so much of a twist. From his chest, it's literally an unfolding that way. Good. Keep your head steady. Good. Come back to center. Good. Stay in lotus. Nice and easy. Lower down. Lower down. Stay in lotus. Back. Lower your hands. Lower your hands. Unfold the spine. Nice and slow. Stay back. Stay back. Stay back. In lotus. Now, keep lotus and lower the legs to the ground. This is an amazing front body opener. Feels good, huh? Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it stretches all the psoas, all the hip flexors. Good. And then as you're ready, you can come out. Good. Yeah, just come here and then release the legs. Again, this is where he was when he came into it, just out. Okay. I will show really quick. I'll have to go to the side because I have a battery pack on my back. Okay, so my hand, I'll lower the hips and I'll actually place my hips on my hand so that battery pack is there. And then I open up this way. You see that? So my hips are still in line with my shoulder and go this way. Gravity is real, okay? So as you open up, there will be a lot of pressure on your hand and you don't want to go too far because gravity will take you over, okay? And then you can even play with the balance. Then as you come out, nice and sweet. Just come out and stretch. Is there a mic here someplace? Yeah. Okay. All right, guys, let's do it. Okay. Lay on your backs, feet facing forward, heads towards the back of the room. If you have a ponytail or something, back of the head should be flat. Yeah, I'm good. Legs overhead, bend your knees in as you go over. You can start in halasana, toes on the floor, work towards it, just to get the length of the spine towards the sky. Keep your throat open. Yeah, take your hands to the lower back for support. Your hands are there to keep the spine lengthening towards the ceiling. Take the legs towards the sky, nice and easy, one at a time. There you go. There you go. Perfect. Fantastic. Throat open, shoulders back. That's it. I'm going to grab your ankles, and I'm going to give you a little lift to bring your elbows in. How's that feel? Yeah, that's very good. Okay, now to the best of your ability, this is totally cool, and you can even work it here. To the best of the ability, right foot in, bring it heel deep onto the hip flexor if you can. Nice, Todd. Bend at the hips, and then cross the second leg over. Yeah, your head and shoulders stay stable. You will most likely be burning brain cells that you've never used before, so don't worry about it. That's it. Keep working it. Good. And then switch legs. Okay. Cross it over. Yeah, good, Bonnie. You got it. Yeah, you got it. You got it. It's tempting to just grab that foot and pull it in, right? There you go. Yeah, that's it. That's it. That's it. Very good. Now, the lotus of your choice, whichever side, you can stay in if you're in, switch sides, whichever side is easiest, lotus of your choice. There you go. And then you can work Parsva. So you'll turn your hips. Let's go to the left first. Bend at the hips and then place your hand more on the sacrum and the glute. There it is. Your hand is strong for support, and from your belly start to unfold the lotus. Good, Abdul. More of your hips. Turn your hips 45 degrees to your left. Not a twist. Rotation. There you go. Keep going. Yeah, the other side. Switch. Fantastic. Bring it in and switch. Good. Come back to center. Good. You can stay on lotus or legs overhead, halasana, and then very sweetly unroll yourself to the floor. Good. Nice and easy. If you're in lotus, you can unfold and get a nice front body stretch. Good. That feels good, right? And if you're not in lotus, you can imagine that you're in lotus, right? Just by closing your eyes. Cool. All right. If you're in lotus, you can unfold the legs. You doing? Good. Bring your knees into your chest. Draw your knees in and then just soften. Cool. Close your eyes. Holding your right knee, just stretch your left leg forward to the floor. Good. And as you settle your right knee towards your chest, try to let your left leg get a little heavier towards the ground. And then the bones of the legs will slide apart. You feel that? Good. So the opening is always happening. It's harder to create an opening at the more denser parts of the body. So we just be aware. Feels good. Relax your eyes. There you go. Good. Take a breath. There you go. Good. Very good. Good. Switch legs. Right. Left knee in. And as you draw the left knee in from the center of your hip, just glide the bones of your legs apart. Feels good, right? Good. And then as you soften into this opening, just let the eyes settle into the back of the head. So you just get nice and calm. Feels good, right? Don't worry, Todd. I'm coming, man. I'm coming. Good. Relax. Relax your shoulders, your right shoulder. Good. You just relax. Good. Yeah, that's it. Good. That's it. Good. Shavasana. As you come into Shavasana, just allow the body to unfold to the edges of your mat. If you bump somebody, don't worry about it. Shavasana is an amazing time to plant the seeds of your future. In going back to the beginnings of the tradition of yoga, the very first yogis used to call themselves farmers because they were planting seeds. Well, where were they planting the seeds? They were planting them in the body. What we did today in this practice was a physical experience. But we only work and open the body in the physical so that we can plant the seeds of the spiritual. As you soften in your skin, as you soften in your bones, your body is now receptive to a more powerful message. Ultimately, it's just the very simple message of your heart. What is your truth? What are the seeds that you want to plant in your own soil? If you could think of one message that you wanted to send to your entire body, what is that message? Plant the seed. And oftentimes you will find little parts of your body will have resistance to that message. It's totally cool. You plant the seed, and when the time is right, it will blossom. Continue to nurture it. Continue to feed it. Very sweetly begin to increase your breath. Move your fingers and your toes. And as you're ready, you can start to stretch your arms and your legs. Nice and easy, bend your knees, roll to your right. Then just use your hands to lift you to a seated position. If it feels comfortable, that seated position can be lotus. If not, siddhasana is totally cool too. Siddhasana, just ankles in front of each other. Sukhasana, feet supported on top of each other, shins on feet. Just take a comfortable seat. Sit up tall, take your shoulders back, and bring your hands together at your lotus heart center. Yeah. When we come into a practice like this, it's super important that we recognize that the physical is just one part of it. Ideally, when you come to practice, especially if I'm teaching, I would much rather you leave with a message like, what did you feel? What was the experience? What did you hear? Not what did you do? And ultimately, we use this practice in every sense to connect deeper to ourselves. If you can do lotus, great. But if you can't, it doesn't matter. Ultimately, lotus is just a reflection of a way, one way, not the way, but one way that we can connect to ourselves in a mindful way. When we leave this room, you have every single minute of every single day to practice that action, connecting to yourself. Lotus as a pose, you have your whole lifetime. And if you believe in it, you have many lifetimes to get it down. Okay, remember when the seed is ripe, when the seed is ready and the environment is right, the seed will blossom. Bow your head to your heart. In this practice and in this life, may our mind be a servant of the heart. May they work together just to bring us harmony so that we learn to appreciate this vessel, this instrument that we've been given, and this opportunity that we are in. Thank you guys for such a beautiful, mindful practice. You guys are amazing. Namaste.